Purdue is making its first Elite Eight appearance since 2000, the first in the tenure of Matt Painter as head coach of Purdue. Kind enough to call in to the Rich Eisen Show after that big night. How are you, Coach?
Doing good. Doing good. Thanks for having me on.
Do you say anything to Ryan Klein watching this? Do you, or you just leave him alone? What's your coaching philosophy when you see that kid throw it in that?
He got into a pretty good rhythm there. And, to start the second half, he got into a couple dribble handoffs and a couple pin downs where he knocked shots down. And then from there, he just kind of kept answering them. We really didn't have an answer for Tennessee. They made that huge run in the second half, and we're having a tough time stopping them, tough time getting a rebound. So, we had to score the basketball, and it seemed like he answered the bell on about three or four possessions that, we were stuck, where if, we don't get something positive that possession, they just had so much momentum that it was going to be hard for us.
So you were dialing up plays for him, essentially.
We're trying to. A couple of those things were just him making plays on his own after things broke down at the end of the play. But, he would get a switch, and then he was kind of jockeying back and forth just to try to kind of get some space or get by him for a pull-up, and he knocked down some tough shots.
Yeah, Nett didn't even move on some of them.
I didn't realize until you go back and watch it on tape that, everyone, it seemed like every single one of those shots, was pure and it was going right in and the net wasn't moving.
Yeah, the step back to tie it at 80. That one was, just so you know, I was in Anaheim getting set to watch my alma mater that you know obviously well in the Big Ten, and the arena was going nuts. They had it on the arena. They had it on the big screen. When he tied the game at 80, it was the loudest cheer of the night, and that included both of the games that was before and after that actually was played. It was unbelievable. Coach,
that's cool that they sit there and be watching that, and it's always you want your conference to do well, and so seeing other people, and we were in to go to the Sweet 16 about 7-8 years ago, and Michigan State ended up going to the Final Four. I think it was 2009, and one of their players, Corey Lucius, hit a shot, I think it was against Iowa State, and we were waiting to play the next game to play Texas A&M, which we ended up winning, and we went to the Sweet 16 ourselves. But just to be in that hallway when Corey, I think it was Corey Lucius, don't hold me to that, but for Michigan State, our guys were naturally, just organically excited for Michigan State and their advancement to the Sweet 16. Obviously, you go to battle with these guys, but to see our guys just kind of naturally react and be pulling for them to win that game. So that's pretty cool when you hear about things like this and Klein making those shots, and Michigan fans are, over on the West Coast rooting for Purdue.
Yeah, I'll tell you, man, it was something. Did you ever have a night like that for Katie?
No. Players like me go into coaching, yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah, no, the guys that average 4 don't only have nights like that. So, he was one of those guys that when you took him out of high school, there was no question he could shoot the ball. He was going to compete. He came from a great program in Indianapolis, Carmel High School. But there were some things, from a defensive standpoint and being able to move laterally that, he had to be able to work on. But he's been great for us. He's gotten better each year defensively. Just a great team guy, but has a level of toughness to him. You don't make those kind of shots just because you've got a great jump shot, and that's it. He's got a little mental toughness to him, especially after he gets it going.
Man, you got the Lightning in Carson Edwards too, who's the current leading scorer of the entire NCAA tournament. Are you talking about cutting down nets? What is your philosophy here? Do you just come out flat out and say it right now that you have a shot?
Well, yeah, you obviously put yourself in that position. It's one thing about talking about, going to a Sweet 16 or an Elite Eight or a Final Four. You got to get yourself in that position, and our guys have been able to do that. But we got a tough task in front of us. Virginia is very good, very mentally, physically tough, great coach. We're going to have to play well. We're going to have to shoot the ball well. It was crazy last night in our game, Tennessee and us, we both shot 50% from the free throw line and 50% from three. And I don't think I've ever seen a box score that way.
That's right.
From two good teams that can't make a free throw but can make tough threes.
It was insane. It really was. Matt Painter, a few more minutes left with the Purdue head coach here. So walk the listeners and viewers of this show through. You hang up and you're just going to be grinding Virginia tape for the rest of the day? I mean, you've got a short turnaround here, obviously, against a very tough one seed.
Yeah, well, we play a night game tomorrow. So just, you know, both teams, like, you know, you try to settle in after having a long night and obviously a very emotional night of, you know, playing and winning and grinding out. We obviously had an overtime game, but we were the first game. So, you know, we'll go and do a walkthrough now, you know, shoot some free throws, stretch. That's about it. We don't do a whole lot in between. Just get ready for tomorrow, watch a lot of tape, you know, get off our feet and just get focused. But, you know, the most important team's yours. And this is going to be a very, very difficult game, but it's also one of those games that you kind of dream about. That's what I told our guys. I said, you dream about winning a Big Ten championship. You dream about getting into the NCAA tournament. But now having a chance to play, you know, for a Final Four, you know, you just got to lay it all on the line. But you also have to have a looseness about you. And I thought we showed that last night. We struggled in some areas, but we also had some really, really good stretches. But our guys played with a little bit of a looseness. And you can still use that word and have discipline and have an edge to you. And so, but when you're shooting the basketball and you're moving on offense, man, you know, you have to be ready to shoot. You got to be ready to play. And you got to believe in yourself.
Now, I'm just wondering what it's like for you, having, you know, spent as much time as you did at Purdue as a player for Gene Katie. You are now the second most tenured coach in the Big Ten behind Tom Izzo. And there's Gene Katie in the row behind you, mm-hmm. watching you coach, watching this team go through, trying to get to the first Final Four appearance for the school since Katie's first year there back in 1980. Do you pause for a second and wonder what the kid who played at Purdue would think about this whole situation?
A little bit. You know, obviously, you've been somewhere for a while. I was there 4 years as a player, 1 year as an assistant. Now this is my 14th year as the head coach. But, you know, I feel like I have an advantage over a lot of guys that take jobs just because this is my alma mater, but also the blueprint of what he created and his discipline. And, you know, he has a great program. I think anybody can have a good team, but can you have a good program and have consistency and graduate your guys and do it the right way? And so, you know, from him and, you know, Bruce Weber, you know, I learned from two really good guys that get it. So I think that's definitely helped us in our league. It's important to know how to navigate within your league. And obviously those two guys were very successful, you know, at Purdue in the Big Ten.
Do you hear from Breeze every now and then?
I read his tweets. I don't know him personally, so it's not. But yeah, I kind of stay in my own lane. But no, I'm a big Drew Breeze fan, and so I grew up rooting for the Steelers, but I always root for Drew Breeze. Plays. I root for the Colts too, but like, 1976, the Saints weren't doing great. But the Steelers were, and Franco Harris was my favorite player, so I've always been a Steelers fan. But Drew Brees has been unbelievable for our school. There's a lot of guys that, you know, do well and have success that are, you know, marquee-type guys, Hall of Fame, you know, type guys. But he's given back so much to Purdue, and we're really grateful for him.
So, I mean, you want me to make that connection? I can make that happen. I should do this.
I'm trying for him to have one less person bother him in his life. So
okay.
He can just enjoy here the last, you know, whatever it is. Probably for him, probably the last 5 years of his career, knowing the success he's had and how well he's done.
Yeah, I mean, and again, I guess it's the color scheme. Steelers and obviously Purdue's color scheme is pretty close. So last one for you. What do you bring to the fore more from your playing days as a coach right now? Your playing days in Purdue or being on the fictitious Coast Squad in the movie Blue Chips back in the day?
Probably more from playing. I think the one thing about just being a below average player is that you have the feel for a lot of people on your team, especially a guy who is at the end of a rotation, who is out of a rotation, who's trying to find his way. You know how they feel and you know what they go through. And so I always try to be, you know, understanding of that and try to communicate that with them to a degree. But some guys that, you know, that are struggling, the last thing they need is some hot air. You know, you have to be honest with guys and try to help them get to where they want to be and also let them know that it's a process. So I think that's a big part of, you know, I had 4 years where one year I didn't play. Another year I played 10 minutes. A third year I played 20 minutes. My last year I played 30 minutes. So I had a pretty good feel, you know, for what our guys go through and kind of that emotional roller coaster of sometimes playing or sometimes playing a role. And I think that's what our guys have done, especially our freshmen. They've done a good job of playing roles, and they know that their value they bring to the team is going to be in short spurts, but it's still important.
There were no pickup games on the set of Blue Chips, Matt?
There was. It was really good pickup games. So a lot of the guys that were in the area got to play, and that was me. Mm-hmm. I got thrown in there. Then a lot of guys that were going into that draft, in a lot of players that were either going to be free agents that didn't get drafted were kind of in that movie. So if you can kind of pick and pull some of those guys.
Shaq, obviously.
Yeah, Shaq is different. He was the star. Him and Penny were the stars. But, guys like Thomas Hill, Allen Houston, Adonis Jordan, Roddy Rogers, a lot of different guys just playing Rex Walters, just playing pickup every single day for about, I'd say it was like 3 days. But it was pretty cool. It was pretty cool to get to a couple pickup games, $150 a day.
There you go.
Eat a couple times. You're 22 years old, throwing in a couple meals. That's pretty beneficial.
Well, if Allen Houston got you in that game in Blue Chips, you certainly got him back last night with Carson Edwards and
Allen Houston Ryan Klein. Is my age, and so we played AAU against his teams, and we played the Indiana Kentucky All-Stars against him. And so he was great, man. He was a great guy, and he was a great player. And but I didn't think along those lines of him playing.
That's my job. Hey, look, you're on to Virginia already. It's my job to to connect these lines. Coach, thanks for the call. Really appreciate it. I know you're very busy.
Thanks
you're in the midst of the big thing.
Oh,
of course. Congratulations. Right, congrats on that last night. You bet. That's Matt Painter, Purdue head coach.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.